Now let's consider line integrals and cylindrical coordinates, and let's do it the same way, the same process that we did when we did the rectangular coordinate system. In fact, let's consider the exact same piece of wire that has 4 coulombs per meter charge on it, and I want to know its total charge over a length from 0 to 4 meters. Well, the way that I did that before is I was going to do an integral. Line integral is only one, and I need to put my element over here, dl. Is this going to be a scalar value or a vector value? Since this is scalar, then my dl is also going to be a scalar value. Now I need to decide which part of dl to use. This is my dl component right here. And to do that, I'm going to decide what is changing. And let's do that in spherical coordinates. Over the length of this line right here, is the r value changing? Here's the value r, 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 r. The radius of this wire from the center is always the same, so dr is equal to 0. How about d phi? Here is phi. And this wire is always here at phi equal 90 degrees, so d phi is also equal to 0. Does z change? Yes. Over the length of this line, dz is not equal to 0. Now let's go look at our line terms. Is our dr equal to 0? Yes. Our dr is 0. And right here, our d phi term is 0. So this value right here is the only one that I'm going to be using for my dl, and I need the scalar part. So dl is equal to dz. I'm going to put my function 4 coulombs per meter here, and I'm going to integrate from z equals 0 to 4 meters. So I'm going to get 4 coulombs per meter times z from 0 to 4, which is going to give me 16 coulombs per meter, just as it did before. Now let's imagine what would have happened if I had been integrating a wire that was shaped like an arc, that was a quarter of a moon like this. So let's do that one actually in red, just as an example. So this arc right here, instead of integrating over dz, what would be changing? D phi would be the term that was changing, so my integral right here would have an r d phi component, and let's say that this is also 4 coulombs per meter in here. And now let's see, phi is going to vary from 0, right here is phi equals 0, and here is phi equals 90 degrees. So from phi equals 0 to phi equals 90 degrees, and I need to multiply that by r. So instead of 90 degrees, let me use pi by 4, and now I need an r value. Let's say that the r is 1 meter. Let's plug that in there. So I'm going to end up with 4 coulombs per meter times r, which is 1 meter, times phi from 0 to pi by 4. So when I get my answer, it's going to be 4 times pi by 4 coulombs, or pi coulombs, for this little piece of line.